Hi everyone. I was gone for quite a while now, and this is mainly because I am studying architecture, and being an architecture student can be quite stressful most of the times. But this is the main reason I'm making this video, just to chat and give you some advice on how to manage these stressful times, whether you're at school or your 9-to-5 job or your family. The situation doesn't really matter. Just let's talk, let's chat, how to manage your stressful life. So the stress that I was in is quite different from a 9-to-5 kind of stress or a family kind of stress, because this period of exam seasons is kind of short. I mean, it's basically like 2 months and that's it, but it can be really, really intense. That's why I haven't posted any videos, any shorts even. And I have some tips on how I manage these short periods of stressful times. And maybe you can use these tips and tricks and apply it to your stressful life to make it not so stressful and a lot more productive and happy. And again, I'm talking from a perspective of a really, really short period of time, but a very, very stressful time. And the thing that helps me the most is to really understand my tasks, my missions, my daily tasks, my daily missions, and to organize it by any order that fits you. So the way I do it is actually analyzing all the tasks that I have for the upcoming week or day. I do it regularly on a weekly basis and not on a daily basis, but if you know you're gonna have some very, very stressful days, then I do recommend doing it on a daily basis. Gathering all your tasks and knowing how much time every task will take, and then building yourself an hourly based schedule that you can fit all your tasks in it. And I know this advice might sound a little bit too obvious, but I can promise you that if you are watching this video, chances are you are not doing it, or you are not doing it the right way. So just make a list with all the tasks you have for the upcoming week, their deadlines, and how much time you think every task will take. After that, use Google Calendar. And if you are a kind of person that cannot handle digital journals, then you can also buy yourself a regular journal. I do it as well. And just write all these tasks in the place they belong. And you know, doing all these things does not guarantee you having a stress-free life. And actually, you really need to build yourself this kind of mentality where deadlines are the most important thing, and you cannot and you won't let yourself procrastinating things. It's this just kind of a self-discipline that if you have a task that its deadline is in 2 days, then you will make sure that this task is done today if its deadline is in 2 days, because I feel that's the way to go. You know, you don't want to get to the deadline day and be stressed out that this task is not complete. And actually, the way I think you can start developing yourself this some kind of self-discipline and this strict way of working is actually by implementing the practices from the 5-second rule book. I read this book in Hebrew. You can read it if you want, but I just want to share with you the one most important point that I got from this book, and it really relates to the self-discipline theme. So actually, the main point that I got from this book is, if you're not going to do something that pops into your mind in the next 5 seconds, it will probably not happen at all. Meaning that if I have this task that I want to start, if I'm not going to get up, open my computer, open a Word document and start typing, then it's not gonna happen. It's not gonna happen in the next hour. It's not gonna happen all day long. It may not happen all week. So just try to have this state of mind for a week, for maybe even just a day, that if something pops into your mind and you're not doing anything with it in the next 5 seconds, then you will probably not do it at all. And this can be applied to every kind of task you have in your life. It can be working out, it can be cooking, it can be, I don't know, grocery shopping. It can be really everything you can think about. Just put inside your brain that if you're not going to do it in the next 5 seconds, if you're not going to do anything about it in the next 5 seconds, that it probably won't happen at all. And I know that it may be a little bit harsh to think that way, and it may be a little bit too strict to be in this state of mind all the time, but if that is what's going to make you be active and do the things you need to do in their time, then let it be. So after having all your tasks and all your deadlines and all the listing of the time it takes and the will to start these tasks, another thing in this story to stay sane is to know when to take breaks and when to just let yourself do nothing. You know, in this very stressful times of exam seasons in architecture school, you really, really have to take breaks. It's basically mandatory. If you do anything creative as your job, taking breaks is mandatory, and without taking any breaks, then your mind cannot have new ideas and new thoughts. And these breaks are just mandatory for staying sane. And you can't just say to yourself that you're going to take a break somewhere in the day. You really need to put these breaks inside your schedule along with the tasks you have to do. The breaks are maybe not as important as the tasks, but they are so important because you are going to be better at those tasks with the breaks you take. You will have more time to think, more time to analyze, more time to have new ideas and better ideas. And this time you will just let your brain have a little rest, you know? And the last thing I'm going to talk about is actually that it is okay to find comfort in people that are going through the same stress that you are going. It might not help you build the perfect schedule, but knowing that there are people that are going the exact same experience that you do sometimes can make you a little less stressed out, because you know that people just like you are going through the same things and they are okay. So actually, I'm not sure if this video was helpful to anyone. I just wanted to share my experience and the way I manage my time in this stressful period of exam season as a first year architecture student. But if you did find this video helpful, I would really appreciate if you give this video a thumbs up, or maybe you would like to see more videos like this, or maybe just on how it is to be an architecture student in Israel. Subscribe to this channel and write down below what you want to see next. And that's it. See you next time.